Hello my dear students, how are you? I hope all of you are safe at home and in good health. I thought, as a teacher, what can I do to boost the morale of my students during these hard times? And the answer I received was stories. Students of any age group, though I know my stakeholders are youngsters, still they love the stories. They like to listen the stories. So I will try to narrate you world famous stories of acclaimed short story writers from all over the world. I hope after listening to these short stories, you will be happy, energetic, enthusiastic, and capable to tackle and handle all your day-to-day problems, as the characters depicted in these short stories also face problems in their lives and they try to find out the solutions. Today I am going to narrate you a story, The Homecoming by Rabindranath Tagore, who is the only author from India who has received Nobel Prize for Literature. So let us start the story. Pathik, the main character in the story, along with his friends and younger brother Makhan, was playing on the banks of river. Pathik was very mischievous boy and his favorite pastime was to tease his younger brother Makhan. Now also he was doing the same thing. There was a log of wood lying in the mud flat of the river waiting to be turned into a boat. He decided to roll the log in the river so the owner of the log will be surprised and angry and all of them would enjoy the fun. Makhan, however, was sitting on the log of a wood which was on the bank of river. Pathik ordered Makhan to move away from that log. But Makhan was his brother. He was also an adamant boy and he refused to move. Pathik tried to push him away, threatened him, but Makhan was stuck to that log. Therefore, Pathik ordered his friends to push the log, to roll the log along with Makhan in the river. All the boys with all their might pushed the log of wood in the river and Makhan lost his balance and fell in muddy water. He started shouting and tried to beat his elder brother Pathik. But Pathik was a big boy. He thrashed Makhan thoroughly. Makhan, with no other choice, went home crying. And Pathik sat on the sunken barge, chewing a piece of grass. A middle-aged man with grey hair stepped on the shore from a boat. He asked Pathik where Chakravartis lived. Pathik pointed in a direction and said, "Over there." But it was impossible to guess where he pointed. At the same time, a servant from his house arrived and ordered him to come home immediately. At home, mother was furious over his behavior and asked him why he pushed Makhan in the river and hit him. In the beginning, he denied that he hit Makhan, but angrily again, he thrashed Makhan in front of his mother. His mother shouted, "You little villain, would you hit your mother also?" At this critical juncture, the person on the river bank entered. His mother shouted, "Dada, you are here. I can't believe." Bishambar, her brother, had shifted to Bombay after her marriage. Now he had shifted again to Calcutta and he immediately came to inquire about his sister, as her husband died when he was in Bombay. For next few days, the brother lived with his sister and her boys. When he came to know about Pathik, that he was a complete nuisance, wild, disobedient, lazy boy, he suggested her sister he will take the child with him to Calcutta for further education. The widowed mother readily agreed. Pathik was very excited and his joy knew no bounds at the thought of shifting to Calcutta. His mother was relieved at the thought of getting rid of Pathik. But she was distressed also, as Pathik was eager to move to Calcutta. While living to Calcutta, Pathik gave his fishing rod, marbles, kite to his younger brother. When they reached Calcutta, his auntie wasn't happy with this unnecessary addition to her family. She had already had enough to manage her three boys, and this one more boy of 14 years of age, an adolescent, was terribly upsetting sight for her. An adolescent, she thought, is nothing but a nuisance. The boy is nor ornamental nor youthful. He can't be loved, as he is not a child. And even he is not a grown-up boy, so his talks are resented by all the members of the family. The adolescent boy is unattractive, his hoarse growing voice. In addition to that, the boy is painfully self-conscious. But his heart always craves for recognition and love. And such a boy can be slave of anyone who shows him consideration. An adolescent boy almost becomes like a stray dog without a master. For a boy of 14, his own home is paradise. Living in a stranger's home is like punishment. Pathik realized this soon. He was an unwelcome guest in the house. The cramped atmosphere of neglect almost choked him. But there was no free space in Calcutta, surrounded by houses from all sides. Always he recalled the green meadows of his village, where he wandered like a free bird. He missed the brook where he swam to his wish, his kite flying sessions, his friends with whom he did what he pleased, and even he remembered his prejudiced mother. In the school of Calcutta, he proved to be the most backward boy, who was unable to answer a single question. After returning home, when all other boys used to play, he stayed in home and gazed at them. He longed to go back to his home at village. His uncle told him he can go to village during holidays. One day he lost his lesson book, and with all his courage, he asked his aunt for a new one. But he got nothing but just scolding. That day, while returning back from home, back from school to home, he was shivering and had high fever. Next day, Pathik ran away from home. It was heavily raining. His uncle complained to police, and police found him completely drenched. His face flushing red with fever, limbs trembling. They brought him back. He only uttered, "Uncle, I was going back home," and he fainted. The whole night he was delirious and muttering, "Uncle, have the holidays come and may I go home?" Day by day his condition became critical. Uncle sent a message to his mother. Pathik was crying and uttering, "By the mark, 3 fathoms. By the mark, 4 fathoms. He had heard sailors calling out the mark on the plumb line. Now he thought his own ship was sinking in an unfathomable sea. His mother arrived like a whirlwind and hugged him and said, my darling Pathik." He saw his mother and said, "Mother, the holidays have come." And here the story ends. This story is about an adolescent boy, Pathik, who hates his mother in the beginning because she tries to discipline him. But at the end of the story, he realizes the value of his hometown and mother's unconditional love. The story also speaks about the storm in the minds of the adolescent youths. These youths, they are no more innocent children, but they are no more mature men even. There is only one condition that they should be understood by their friends, by their relatives, and by their parents. This is the underlying message in this story. I hope you have liked this story. Thank you very much. Keep watching.